Welcome to the Dr. Pepper Cup Series Season 3, race number 5, the second to last race of this season, comes to us from Franklin Motor Speedway to the Franklin 500. 13 drivers prepared to roll off at this really small tri-oval racetrack. This is a very, very small racetrack. We'll have to watch out for lap cars today, because this track is really, really tiny. As we get ready for the roll-off, new paint schemes for the 88 and the 48, Jimmy Johnson and Dale Earnhardt Jr. Jeff Gordon leads the point standings, hoping to keep it today with a nice finish. Casey Kane wants to bounce back up to the front in the point standings. And drivers, start your engines. As now the field will roll off here. Row 1, you'll find Carl Edwards along with Casey Kane. Row 2, you'll find Brad Keselowski and Tony Stewart, who's another contender for the championship. Row 3, you'll find A.J. Allmendinger and the 20 of Matt Kenseth, who's currently second in points. In row 4, you'll find Joey Logano and Kurt Busch, who's had some good finishes all season. Row 5 is Jeff Gordon, your points leader, and Eric Almirola. Row number 6, you'll find Dale Earnhardt Jr. and Jimmy Johnson, both teammates with new schemes. Finally, in row 7, the previous race winner, Chris Harvick. Here's your track facts presented by Nascar&Minecraft. 13 cars, 12 laps. It's actually 11 laps. Just put it wrong on there. Watch for lap cars today. Edwards is on the pole today, and we are ready for race 5. Here we are. Green flag is out and away. Carl Edwards leads him down here. Casey Kane on the outside trying to get around him. Aw, man. Can't do it as we head on to lap 2. Tony Stewart using the outside lane there. He's in 4th right now as Casey Kane trying to shake Brad Keselowski off his tail. Those two are battling for position as we move on to lap 3. Already a big battle as we go on board with Carl Edwards. As they come around the tri-oval, Carl Edwards leads them on to lap 4, I believe. Yes, lap 4. We're already on lap 4, almost a few laps away from halfway. As here comes Casey Kane still trying to get around the 2 car. As we haven't had a caution yet, and there's Chris Harley and a few other cars. You can see them in the back. Carl Edwards is catching up to them. We'll see if he can catch them by the end of the race. On board with Brad Keselowski. Here he comes down the back, the front stretch. The start-finish line is located on what normally would be the back stretch, as you see him coming around. And Chris Harley is on pit road. Oh no, something's going on. As we move on to the final laps of this race, Chris Harley is on pit road. Let's see what's going on. It looks like he's going to be taking 4 tires. I'm not sure. Maybe he made contact with another driver. There he goes. On to lap 9, I believe. And there goes Chris Harley in the inside wall. But we keep going. Casey Kane still trying to get around the 2 car. Here they come back around. And Joey Logano gets turned and it will end the race. Oh man, Joey Logano gets turned. That will end the race. As the race ends under caution, Carl Edwards wins race 5. Joey Logano will finish 12th because Chris Harley was lapped down, fell behind him. Here's your finishing order. Michael Cena gets his first ever win. Cool Candy 241 gets second. That'll boost him up in the points. Raja Karuth is going to be racing the number 32 car in the finale opposed to the number 2 car. As here are your point standings. Everybody with stars next to their points calculations are in it to win it. They are in the chase. Anybody with nothing by their points calculations, they are a wild card. Anything with an X, well, they're eliminated from points contention. So we have 3 cars out of it. All right. Congrats to Michael Cena on his win today at Franklin. The finale will be at Dover for the FedEx 500. Thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks for subscribing, too. This whole thing has been really great. This is EPRN Films 2014 Productions.